folks, that there is the sun, the great burning fireball in the sky. But you already knew that, and you're like, why am I talking about the sun? Well, here in the north of England, I haven't seen it for literally weeks, and it's the height of summer, and I'm really frustrated, as you can probably tell by this mini rant, because I haven't been able to review this fancy new scooter. But alas, hallelujah, today's the day, the sun is out, it's glorious, so I should probably get on with it. Let's go. But first, time for a frankly over-the-top unboxing. Do people still watch unboxings anyway? So there you have it, after that pointless drone unboxing, here is your contents. You've obviously got the scooter, a charger, a manual, and some tools for assembly, because as you can see, assembly is clearly required. So roll up your sleeves and wrangle the scooter by first attaching the handlebars. Not that way, you tool! Speaking of tools, use your included tool to screw in the screws hard.
Hey, keep it PG.
All right.
Oh, and you should probably fix the brake lever whilst you're at it.
Speaking of brakes, if they're too loose, have a little play with this knob and you can tighten them. Genius. And hey, presto, you've assembled an electric scooter. You're basically a mechanic now, so take a load off. Or not. In fact, let's just get on with the review. Come on, get a move on. There is an elusive mantle in the electric scooter world, and I like to call that mantle. It is a scooter that is so powerful and so popular that it can eclipse the popularity and success of the Xiaomi M365 or the M365 Pro, whilst at the same time correcting some of the Xiaomi's mistakes.
The Pure Air Pro came close by refining the build quality, making it super water resistant and giving you those big old 10-inch air-filled tyres, but there was no suspension. The HiBoy S2 gave you a higher top speed suspension and at a competitive price tag, but it had the smaller 8-inch rubber wheels, so back to the drawing board.
Few scooters have come close, but none have quite managed to give you everything that you want from the Xiaomi killer. But today, we may have found that. How close can I get to my eyeball?
This is the Reed E4 Plus, an entry-level commuter scooter. It's got a top speed of 15.5 miles per hour, a range of 17 miles, 350 watt motor, a 36 volt 7.5 amp hour battery. It's got 10-inch rubber tyres, rear suspension, an e-brake and a disc brake, and it's priced at $599. Link to scooter in Doth Bio.
Alrighty guys, let's take a closer look at the scooter. We've got nice wide handlebars, a nice squeezy comfortable grip. The throttle's a bit plastic. But I do like the display. It's nice and big, nice and bright, shows how much battery you've got in, what mode you're in, how fast you're going, Bluetooth lights and all the usual stuff. We do only have the one real brake. It's a mechanical disc brake at the back, but when you press it, it does connect with an electronic brake in the front wheel, which should help the braking distance. The headlight is nice and bright. It's nice and large as well, which makes a nice change. It's also good to see that the wires are nicely housed and they're not really kind of flailing around like on other scooters. The base plate isn't the widest or the longest base plate I've ever seen, but it'll do the job for most people and you can stand in parallel like I do. The overall build quality is pretty decent. It uses the same chassis, the same body as the Xiaomi scooters, but with some important upgrades such as a new folding stem, which we'll have a look at in a moment, but a big standout feature is the 10-inch wheels. Everyone wants bigger wheels these days and this one delivers. Both wheels are hard rubber so you won't get a puncture, but I know a lot of people still prefer pneumatic tires, but I'm happy not to get a puncture, thanks. The rear fender on the Reed can actually be pushed down and used as a stomp brake, unlike the Xiaomi scooters, which is pretty good if you like to use a stomp brake. The rear light is also very big, very bright, and we also have some nice reflectors. Oh, and scooter manufacturers, take note, this is how you make a kickstand. Big, solid, not plasticky, not flimsy, and most importantly, it does the job. And yes, it does have suspension. Kiss my ass, Xiaomi. That's what it would probably say if it could talk. But I'm pleased to say it's pretty decent too. It makes for a very comfortable ride, especially paired with those larger wheels. Oh, and did I mention, it's got underside lighting. Whee! Which you can control in the app. That's right, you can also lock and unlock the scooter, play with certain settings, and even check the health of your scooter, which is quite nice. Technology, eh? What can't it do? Folding mechanisms on scooters can always be a bit of a sticking point, quite literally, and sometimes they get shaky and rattly. Thankfully, the one on the Reed is one of the safest and smoothest I think I've ever come across. And bonus points, the scooter's pretty light too. But it's still heavy enough if you fancy a gym workout. And folding up isn't gonna break your back either. See, what did I tell you? I don't like the look of those clouds. Rains are coming, I gotta finish the review. The scooter in its folded form is pretty small, pretty portable, pretty light, pretty normal, I guess. Apparently you can remove the handlebar grips, which is great for storage, but I'm not quite sure how.
I don't know how to do it.
So I have to say, I did find the Reed very aesthetically pleasing. The beefier 10-inch tyres, wheels, make it look a bit more macho than its Xiaomi cousin. Oh, and yes, you can use it as a manual kick scooter if you run out of battery. Forget about everything I have just said. The real deal breaker is coming up. We all know the most important thing about any electric scooter is the bell test. Here we go. Ooh, I like it. Okay, speed test for you. Quick push to get us going. Pedal to the metal. Let's go, 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 go. A little bit of wind resistance, but we're already 25. That was quick. Here's Fox coming in hot. Oh, 5 long strides is the braking distance. Certainly not the best braking distance in the world. Let's try again with the stomp brake and oh dear, even worse. Ah, well, you can't win them all.
They must be powerful because I've seen two people on them and they're flying off.
Swap your van. No, you need that.
I like the seats. I'll see you, mate.
All right, all the best. That's one thing you can guarantee when you get a scooter. Attention. A lot of people want to know about them. A lot of people want to talk about them. But we've got to be responsible. There's a lot of divvies out there. You know who you are. Stop riding like a divvy. Wear one of these.
A few moments later.
See, I told you the weather wouldn't last. Word to the wise, guys. Rubber non-pneumatic tyres are great for not getting punctures. But in these kind of conditions, a little bit wet, a little bit slippy, you do lose a bit of traction, especially whilst braking, so something to be aware of. But whilst we're here, let's do a hill test. Right, guys, here we go. We've got a decent run up and we're climbing it pretty well. It's a pretty steep hill and we're doing absolutely fine, actually. Pretty impressed here. 350 watt motor, and yeah, I was very happy with that. Alas, the search for the perfect scooter goes on. The Reed E4 Plus came pretty close. I would probably get one over the Xiaomi Pro personally because I like the big, fat, hard rubber tires, no punctures, and obviously the suspension is a massive plus for me. But saying all that, in these kind of wet, windy conditions, I do miss the extra traction you get off the air-filled pneumatic tires, so it's like, what do you do? But price-wise, this is very similar to the M365 Pro, which is kind of what it's going head-to-head against. But I'm pretty sure this won't have as much range as a Pro because the battery is a fair bit smaller. So is this scooter the fabled Giant Killer? Well, that's for you to decide, really. So let us know in the comments below what you think. You really need to try these things before you buy these things. So I'm going to link to a company below called Fat Llama where you can rent scooters from. You get £20 free credit if you use that link. Give it a go and let me know. So until then, I will keep searching. I will keep my eyes open and I will probably make a video about it and and post it on this channel, if I ever find it, that is. But I hope you enjoyed this video. I had a lot of fun reviewing the E4 Plus. Check it out in the links below. Let me know what you think. And you know what to do. Like, subscribe, comment, all that jazz. And we'll see you in the next one.